My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. Hallelujah. Greetings. I am Pastor Calvin Mills of the Church of God Holiness in Barbers Bay, the very sanctuary in which I stand to declare this message to you today. Amen. I'm thankful for JTV. Amen. For partnering with me and bringing you glad tidings from God's Holy Word. And we want you to be inspired and encouraged because God has not forgotten you. He has a plan for your life. Hallelujah. Amen. It's the Advent season, the season of the year we call Christmas. Amen. It's a joyous, festive season. But is it just that for you in the natural with feasting and eating and drinking and merrymaking? Or is it indeed more spiritual and deep within your soul? Well, my friends, I want to challenge you today that God has a plan for your life, and he wants you to give birth to that plan. Sometimes you might feel, I'm a nobody, I'm not recognized, I come from a poor background, a poor family, a poor village, and a poor country, and who is thinking about me? Well, my friends, I'm going to share with you somebody from the Holy Writ that you will be able to identify with, and amen, it will encourage you not to count yourself out. Amen. Don't count yourself out when God indeed is counting you in. Hallelujah. Praise be unto God. The familiar passage of scripture is from the gospel according to St. Luke chapter number 1 verses 26 to 38. We wouldn't read it for time's sake, but we will refer to it, reference it as we go. Amen. But the topic or the subject matter I want to speak to you about is giving birth to God's plan for your life. Giving birth to God's plan for your life. Yes, I know you might be busy doing your own thing, making your own plans, but I want to inform you that God have a plan. He has a plan for you, for your life. It's a plan to prosper you, a plan to give you hope and a future. Praise be unto God. So your future is as bright as the promises of God. And of course, my friend, the story is centered around a virgin girl espoused to be married to a man called Joseph, and she was God's chosen vessel to bring forth his son into the world. Amen. We are speaking about Mary, God's lowly handmaid, unrecognized, probably hidden in obscurity, but God brought her to the light. Amen. We must begin by sharing briefly Mary's situation. Yes, amen, you have a situation, and maybe your situation might want to rob you from God's revelation, but God intervened right in the middle of Mary's situation because she was espoused. She was engaged to be married to a man called Joseph, of course, and none of us, when we are having marital plans, want any interruption, want any invasion into our plan. But I want to tell you, to give birth to God's plan for your life, sometimes you have to be able to experience divine interruptions. Yes, my friend. So while Mary was espoused to be married to Joseph, amen, she was, amen, God's selection. She was God's selection. Though God is divine on earth, God chooses to work through his people. He chooses to walk through us. Amen. To bring his plan to fruition on earth. Amen. And the Son of God was about to make his entrance into earth and to bring God down to earth. The God who transcends on high condescends to come down low in the person of his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. So Mary, amen, was God's selection of the thousands of virgins who could have been chosen and used. She was God's hand-picked servant. I know you're thinking, nobody would pick me. Who would choose me? I don't have a big name behind my first name. My family is not recognized in the city. Well, you're a prime candidate to be selected of God Almighty to bring to birth, amen, his divine plan for such a time as this. Hallelujah. Amen. So Mary was God's selection. And of course, since she was God's selection, God granted her an angelic visitation for the announcement, amen, of God's revelation to her. And Gabriel, we must note his salutation. Amen. He greeted Mary and he said unto her, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." That's the 28th verse of the scripture. Amen. The Lord is with you. What a greeting. What an expressed salutation. Amen. To the selected virgin, chosen of God to bring forth his plan, the birth of his son. Amen. And of course, that salutation from Gabriel led us to Mary's agitation. She was troubled. She was stirred. She was boggled in her mind as to what meaneth this. Yes, God can speak some things in your life that will be mind-boggling, soul-storing. It will make you tremble. It will make you, amen, behave like you're experiencing a tremor. Amen. She was troubled at his salutation, wondering what meaneth this. Yes, when God comes to you, when God's handpick you, when God select you out from among the rest, and God will greet you in an unusual way, you know he is up to something. Have you ever been greeted unusually? I remember 5 years ago, I traveled away to preach the gospel upon my return home. I was greeted by one of my deacons in the church right at the airport. And the kind of greeting, the kind of smile, I knew that something was up, and he blowed my mind because, amen, he was positioned to reveal to me God's provision in the person of a vehicle brand new that I would be driving, amen, throughout my ministry. And so, my friend, it was indeed an interesting salutation, a greeting that had a revelation behind it. Well, we know my friend Mary's situation, we note Mary's Gabriel's salutation, Mary's agitation. We must also note, my friend, that she was troubled, wondering what meaneth this. And then Gabriel went forward to give her the revelation of God's plan. So settle down, calm yourself down, and God will make his plan plain to you if you will listen, if you will focus on him and hear what he has to say to you in this Advent season. The Lord God will give you the revelation that will transform your life forever. And we see that in the 30th through the 33rd verses of our text. Amen. The 30th through the 33rd verses of our text. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid." Many times when God comes to you, when God's spirit overwhelms you, we get afraid and we have a tendency to draw back. But he said, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God." Hallelujah. That's comforting. That's consoling. When you think God didn't have you on his mind, you will find out God have you right in the midst of his plan for what he is doing or about to do in your region, in your territory, this time of the year, this time in the world. Hallelujah. Amen. And he said, "You will conceive in your womb and you will bear a son and you will call his name Jesus." Well, what a revelation. I ain't got babies on my mind. In fact, I don't have my license yet. I'm not a married woman. I'm engaged to be married. So what you mean I will conceive and give birth to a child and I'm about to call his name Jesus? So the revelation is concerning how he was to be born. Amen. It was to be a supernatural conception. Amen. Because that which is to be born in her wouldn't come forth naturally. Amen. From the seed of a man. Amen. And the womb of a woman. But my friend, God will use the woman without the aid afraid of a man because his plan was supernatural and not merely natural. Are you listening to me today? Amen. You shall call his name Jesus. What's in a name? There's meaning, there's significance in a name, because he shall save his people from their sins. He is a savior. He is a deliverer. Amen. He will be great and he will be called the Son of the Most High. Now, the sovereign God is who put this plan together. And you will note, my friend, he being called the Son of the Most High God, he's God's only begotten Son, God's special, unique Son, brought forth into the world in a special, unique way through a virgin woman who would submit to the plan of God. Amen. God said he's to be born a king. Hallelujah. We sing, born a child and yet a king. Hallelujah. He would be born to reign in us. He'd be born to reign over us. He'd be born to bring us peace, joy, love, life, hope, and a future that is endless. Glory be to God. Amen. And he will mean much for Israel, who was looking for their Messiah. God was bringing him forth through Mary. Amen. So there is the revelation concerning Jesus. Amen. The Son of God. Amen. With a supernatural conception in the womb of Mary. Glory to God. Amen. He's unique. He's the only one of his kind. That's why he's termed the God-man, very God and very man, because the Word would made flesh and dwelt among us. Glory be to God. Amen. So Mary got the revelation, but then she still had a question, amen, that was unanswered. So we note Mary's interrogation. She said, well, how can this be, seeing that I know not a man? What do you mean you don't know a man? You have a man called Joseph, yeah? But what she's talking about, I don't know a man intimately. I don't know a man intimately. We have not yet come together, and we have no plan of coming together in sexual intimacy until our marriage is a seal, until a covenant is signed, until it is consummated. Are you hearing me? On that beautiful evening when we come together. But oh, my friend, Gabriel is speaking about the now, God's plan for the now. She asks, how can this be? And Gabriel gave her the explanation. My friend, nothing wrong in asking God questions. Some people say, don't question God. The purpose of interrogation is for clarification, for further revelation, because if you don't comprehend God's plan, then you wouldn't submit to God's plan. Are you hearing me? Mary wanted to know, how can this be? How will this happen? Amen. And Gabriel was glad to give her an explanation. Amen. Gabriel, in the 35th verse of our text, he said, the angel said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High shall overshadow you. Therefore, that child to be born will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God. Hallelujah. That which is to be conceived in you is not from Joseph's seed or semen from Joseph, but from the Spirit of God. It's supernatural. Glory to God. God will make it happen by his power. He will overshadow you, and he will miraculously allow conception to take place, and the child will develop in your womb, and in the fullness of time, you will give birth to the Son of the Living God. And so Gabriel gave her the explanation. Amen. He not only gave her the explanation, but he further gave her some confirmation that this is indeed a plan of God. It's a mind-blowing plan. It's a supernatural plan. It's an unheard-of plan. It's a unique plan. But nevertheless, he gave her confirmation. And you and I need confirmation to the will of God. If we are going to be confident, the will of God must be confirmed in our life. And so Gabriel referred her to Elizabeth, one scripture say her cousin, amen, who was pregnant at this time, about 6 months, amen. She was called barren. She was written off from getting children, but God visited Zechariah and Elizabeth, and God brought forth the prophet of the highest, hallelujah, who would be the forerunner of the Son of the Highest, amen. And God, Gabriel, told her nothing nothing is impossible with God. Now, there's some folks who freak out when they hear about the virgin birth. They can't handle it. They don't believe in it, my friend. But remember, with God, nothing is impossible. We have so many natural, creative miracles today in technology, and they're mind-boggling. They're mind-blowing. We don't understand them, but yet we believe them, and yet our lives are being enhanced by modern-day miracles. I want to tell you, my friend, Jesus Christ was born of a miraculous birth, a supernatural birth. Glory to God. Nothing is impossible with God. To reject the virgin birth of Jesus is to act as if something is impossible with God. And you and I who are being born again, we are not being born again of the flesh. We've been born again of the Spirit. It's a spiritual birth. It is a supernatural birth. Something the Holy Spirit does in us in making us new creatures in Christ Jesus. So my friend, when Mary received the explanation, when Mary received the confirmation, Mary gave submission to the plan of God. Now you see, when God have a plan for you, he wants you to submit freely. He wants you to submit willingly. He wants you to submit fully. He wants you to submit believingly. And Mary said, "Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to your word." Whatever you have said, whatever you have announced, let it come to pass. Glory be to God. And I believe when Mary submitted to the word by faith, then God did what he pledged to do. Hallelujah. Amen. And the supernatural conception took place. Amen. Without the aid of a man. Glory to God. And in the fullness of time, Jesus was born of a virgin. God brought forth his son, and God presented him to the world. Glory to God. And I want to tell you, my friend, God have a plan for you. If you will calm yourself down, if you will, amen, listen to him with an open mind. Yes, his plan is bigger than you. His plan will take his power to bring it to pass. Mary could do nothing without God. It was her overshadowing by God, the Most High, and the Holy Spirit coming upon her. That is what brought forth, my friend, the miraculous birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. What miracle does he want to work in you? What plan does he want to bring birth through you in this season? All he wants is your availability, your believing in his plan, your submission to his plan. And even when nobody knew you, amen, there'll never be a time when you will not be known, because God is going to bring you the forefront of what he is doing in this season. Because of your humility, because of your commitment to him, because of your faith in him. So I tell you, get excited, get ready, for you're going to hear the voice of God. You're going to receive the revelation of the plan of God. Then submit to the Spirit of God and let the supernatural be birthed in you today. So glad to have shared this word with you. I hope you enjoy this festive season. I hope you celebrate not only what God has done in bringing his son, the Lord Jesus Christ, to earth, but you also celebrate what he is doing in you and through you, because he have a plan that he's bringing to birth in your life. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. On behalf of the Church of God Holiness in Bogus Bay, East End, Tortola, on behalf of the management and staff of JTV, a wonderful festive season to all of you.